Our second inductee. She is currently Athletics Director Emeritus for the University of Tennessee after serving as Women's Athletic Director for nearly three decades. In 2005, she was named the Athletic Director of the Year, and in 2016, she earned the Lifetime Achievement Award by Women Leaders in College Sports. She was the first recipient of the NCAA Pat Summit Award in 2017. In 2018, she was the recipient of NACTA's top honor, the James Corbett Award. Ladies and gentlemen, 2019 Women's Basketball Hall of Fame inductee, Joan Cronan.
Hills. Ain't no smoggy smoke on Rocky Top, ain't no telephone bills. Once I had a girl on Rocky Top, half bear, the other half cat. Wild as a mink, but sweet as soda pop, I still dream about that. Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top.
Wow. I think I should have played Oh, What a Night. But I couldn't resist Rocky Top, because I know Tennessee has some worthy opponents in the room, and I wanted to be sure you knew that Rocky Top was just selected as the number one college fight song in America. Luke 12:48. Is my favorite Bible verse. To whom much is given, much is required. I've listened to the gifts and the goals and the accomplishments of my class, and I am so impressed, but I'll tell you what I'm more impressed with is how much they have given back. Let's give them a hand. Thank you. My friend Nancy Wilson called me recently for advice for her acceptance speech into the South Carolina Hall of Fame. And I said, do not mention names, because you will forget someone, and they will probably be the one that wanted to put you in their will. What I think is Beth Bass has tried to get in their will from all of you tonight. But you know, I found it's really hard not to say thanks to so many folks. Alex A. Haley once said, if you see a turtle sitting on top of a fence post, you know someone had to help them get there. I've had lots of people, and I'm that turtle. So tonight I'm going to talk about three groups of people who've made a difference, and three individuals who I think you will recognize. The three groups, the first is family. They always come first. I have two awesome daughters. I have two of the best son-in-laws in the world. And of course, I have five of the cutest grandchildren that have ever been created. We are a family that bleeds orange. In fact, my oldest grandson, Chase, used to call the men's basketball team the Boy Vols. My number two grandson, Reed, the only way you could get his attention and sometimes punish him was to take his orange clothes away and his Adidas clothes, Beth. That got his attention. And of course, my third grandson, Quinn, has been following Beth Bass around, hoping he will get a baseball shoe contract. Now, my two granddaughters who walk me up the aisle, I am so proud of, because they're learning to compete. And they're learning to play and compete, because so many of you in this room work so hard that they can give them opportunities. When I sit back and I think, the first people I have to thank in family is my parents. They told me that I could do anything, and they cheered for me. I also was a little bit embarrassed as my dad sat in the stands and yelled, "Shoot, baby," during my games. But he meant it well, and I did shoot a lot. And today is really special, because it would have been my mother's 99th birthday. Second, I want to recognize my university family. The College of Charleston and UT were two universities that said yes to women before it was cool, and what a journey we had. It gave a 12-year-old, when I was 12, I wanted to play Little League Baseball, and they wouldn't let me play, and I knew what I wanted to do. So these universities gave an opportunity to build programs to help women learn to compete. I could go on and on and on, and I just want to say thank you to the administrators, the coaches, the athletes who shared this dream. I've often said to be successful, you have to have passion, you have to have pride, and you have to surround yourself with the right people. I was so fortunate, and I can name all of your names, and you know who you are. It was so much fun to work with you. The third group is friends. Be sure to take the time to cultivate your friends. I love my friends. And as you might expect, an athletic director has teams of friends. You know, I have my Yaya sisters. I have my tennis group from South Carolina. I have my Charleston buddies. I have my movie group. I have my golf partners. And they all mean so much to me. But there are three individuals that really impact my life that I would like to share with you. You know, Billy Graham said that a coach can influence more people in 1 year than most people do in a lifetime. This is true of my high school coach, Ann Oye, and she is here today. And Ann, would you stand and let us recognize you? Thank you. She coached me her first year out of college, and she stayed and coached for many more years. So, Ann, you made a difference in my life. The second person is someone who has impacted everybody in this room, and that's Pat Summitt. I had the privilege of working with Pat for over 3 decades. And the questions I get asked today are, one, did she stare at you the way she stared at everyone else? You know, our goals and dreams were so similar. Yes, I did get the stare, and we only had one major disagreement, and I thought I was right, so it was okay. But we had a wonderful journey, and that journey included so many of you in this room. So many of you went on that journey with us. And I think tonight we have to thank Pat for so many, many things. I think of Pat when, you know, when we had her celebration of life, 95% of her athletes that she'd coached over 4 decades came back for that celebration of life. And we had called a huddle before we went in for the celebration of life, and I said, never in your lifetime or my lifetime will you know anybody that has won more awards and yet was more humble. That's what Pat was. She was humble, but she led us, and boy, did we enjoy the journey. The third person, of course, is my late husband, Tom. He was my best friend, my partner, and my cheerleader. Of course, he did do a little yelling at the officials along the way. In fact, I remember a game when our friend Sally Bell had officiated the game, and the next morning I went out to the airport. And I sat next to Sally on the plane, and I called Tom to tell him, we're getting ready to take off. Would you like to talk to Sally? And he calmly said, no, I talked to her enough last night. So as I think about the induction into Hall of Fame, from a 12-year-old who wanted to play, to a coach, to an athletic director, it really gives me goosebumps. This is the icing on the cake. This is so special to all of us. And I want to thank the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame. I want to thank the board and the staff, all the sponsors who have really made a difference. In closing, I want to be sure that you know how thankful I am and how proud I am to be living in Knoxville, Tennessee, where the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame is. And remember, in life and in tennis, it is better to serve than receive. Thank you so much.
Once two strangers climbed old Rocky Top looking for a moonshine still. Strangers ain't come down from Rocky Top, reckon they never will. The corn won't grow at all.
Congratulations, Joan.